class.
Nah.
I should have done it. I beat
you. I beat you.
Yeah, like this.
Hey, Moses!
Deborah Targoff, principal of Jennifer Sconzo. Interim Superintendent Guy Sconzo. Aaron Kellert. Alex Shaded. Kimala Combs. Former Superintendent Dr. Betty G. Mason. Trina Brown. Secondly, I would like to call your attention to the symbols that represent various honors that have been received by the members of the class of 2001. The white robe is for the magna cum laude, or the person with the highest grade point average of the entire school. The gold robes are for the valedictorians. Also, the gold cords are for the valedictorians. The blue cords represent Mu Alpha Theta, or the Math Honor Society, and the white stole represents the National Honor Society members. Thank you, and congratulations, class of 2001.
At Klassen's birth, Joyce Henderson took on the task of making us a family. She became Klassen's mother and gave us school spirit. Bill Scoggin took over after Joyce Henderson took on a position in the district's administration building. Mr. Scoggin could always be found in the halls with a smile upon his face. He brought more structure to the school that was still growing. For the last 3 years of our time here at Klassen, Ron Maxfield has been our learning leader. He has guided Klassen into its maturity, integrating Mrs. Henderson's and Mr. Scoggin's accomplishments during their time. All three principals have played integral roles in the developmental process of the schools. And Mrs. Henderson, Mr. Scoggin, and Dr. Maxfield will all be remembered fondly by us as we go forth into the world. Just as they were all here for us as Klassen was growing, so too are they here for us tonight to see us off.
I take great pride in being a part of the class of 2001 birth. 7 years ago, I had the honor to open one of the Oklahoma City Public Schools' magnet schools. At that time, we knew a dream had to be fulfilled. At that time, we started something new in Oklahoma City. And I must say, they looked at you then, and they're looking at you now. Because at that time, excellence was being born. The success of Klassen School of Advanced Studies became one to be reckoned with. We could not go anywhere without everybody wanting to know who the Commons were. Then we were just brand new babies, sixth and seventh graders. At that time, the 10th grade was the highest grade at Klassen. But you have heard how we have grown, how the school has grown. You were good students then, you are better students now, and these students here are now ready to go out into the world and do their very best, because the teachers and the staff at Klassen School of Advanced Studies have prepared them to be the very best. So I leave a quotation of excellence, because I consider this class because you were feeling good then, we all feel good now that you're getting ready to leave the halls of Classen School of Advanced Studies, and you are going to show the world what excellence is all about. Thank you.
As Ms. Henderson had this group of 6th and 7th graders, I had the privilege of having them as 8th and 9th graders. Is there anything in the world more wondrous than 13-year-old girls and 14-year-old boys? The boys are finally starting to notice girls, and the girls have long since passed them by, are only looking at older boys. You combine that with the fact that these are children in the middle school and adults in the high school, and they're in kind of the pretend years in the 8th grade, but the permanent record years in the 9th grade. And it's a wondrous time for all of us to experience. And I remember some of the questions. I heard 8th graders say, why can't I eat with the older kids? And then the 9th grader said, why do I have to eat with the older kids? And I heard 8th graders say, why can't I go to the pep assembly? And 9th graders say, do I have to go to the pep assembly? And 8th graders say, how do I get into IB? And 9th graders say, how do I get out of IB? And 8th graders say, why can't I take phys ed? And 9th graders say, how do I get out of phys ed? And 8th graders say, how come I don't get Ms. Hoyt? And 9th graders say, is there any way I can get out of Ms. Hoyt's class? And I heard 8th graders say, isn't there a way I can take more dance classes? And 9th graders say, what do you mean I have to take 4 dance classes? The changes were enormous. But it was certainly a pleasure to be a part of it. And each of us on this stage takes a special bit of pride and hoping that our touching your lives had just some small effect and some small degree of the effect you had by touching ours. It's a pleasure to share this evening with you.
As Joyce brought her babies into the Classen family and nurtured them for 2 years, the class of 2001 was embarking on a voyage fraught with the obstacles that Jason and the Argonauts could appreciate. As 8th graders, the class looked up to Bill Scoggin, who helped them move from pubescent to that first year of high school. As a new kid who was hardly new, students who experimented with spiked hair, blue hair, spiked collars, and no hair. Students who were once afraid they couldn't find their lockers were now engaged in parking lot wars. Get off the rail was the chant at basketball games, and get to class was the regular sermon. As the mythical grandfather, or maybe more appropriately, the godfather of this group, I counseled and cajoled and worked on helping our students mature into their roles. For 3 exciting years, I've watched you rambunctious, energetic babies of the 6th grade class of 1995 evolve and grow into responsible, caring people. Growth without pain is sometimes impossible, but life without growth is death. Your future awaits you. You are prepared to look it in the face, and when life knocks you down, you will rise stronger and ready to stride forward in the pursuit of excellence. I salute you, class of 2001. Good luck, and God bless you.
Adults among us with the familiar quote, young people just aren't like we were. All those doomsayers, those critics who stand outside the circle, They're afraid to jump in, but they like to stand outside and criticize. But let's just kind of see what the numbers really say. It's one thing to have an opinion, it's something else again to have facts. First of all, since 1932, the average IQ of human beings between the ages of 2 and 75 has increased 3/10 of a point a year, very regularly. The research is very clear that schools have played a unique part in that IQ growth. Please understand what that means. It means that the young people sitting before us have an average IQ approximately 15 points higher than their grandparents and approximately 8 points higher than their parents. It also says to me that the number of children who have IQs of 130 or higher is 7 times that of the previous generation. Now, it's interesting because the previous generation are the people in leadership positions that are now retiring, and they're the ones that are saying these kids don't know anything. That's something to think about. Secondly, I think it's important just to take a look at this class. And let's see what the numbers really tell us. One Fleming scholar, one International Science Fair participant, one All-State pianist, one Intel Science Talent Search winner, one Gold Key National Scholastic Writing Recognition, one first place in the State Junior Academy of Science, two academic All-Staters, two National Achievement Finalists, two National Achievement Referred Students, three Robert Byrd Scholars, three Young Talent Oklahoma Visual Art winners, four Junior Rotarians, five National Merit Scholars, five National Merit Commended Scholars, six History Day National Qualifiers, six Oklahoma Regional Scholastic Art Awards, seven State Superintendent Awards for Arts Excellence, 8 National Council of Teachers of English Achievement and Writing Awards, 15 scores of 30 or higher on the ACT, 20 History Day State Qualifiers, 29 graduates with a 4.0 or higher GPA, 34 Oklahoma Academic Scholars, 56 members of the National Honor Society, 64 graduates with a 3.5 or better, 75 Presidential Excellence Awards, 281 college admissions offered, and $2.5 million offered in scholarships to the class of 2001. You're right. Today's young people aren't like you, and we're glad.
Madness and wonder, and no others will know it as we have. None of the future
future classes will have this memory we share of the opening of this school, of a new idea taking shape amid chaos in a building still under construction, surrounded by the brilliant and brave of Oklahoma City's youth, those willing and able to join in realizing this dream. When Odysseus set out for home at the end of the war, he expected a normal sea voyage. We who entered preparation for the International Baccalaureate program 7 years ago thought we knew what to expect, too. We would take Latin or Greek and two other languages, write a 4,000-word essay, do 150 hours of community service, pass the tests, and get a year of college credit. Like Odysseus, we had no idea what we were getting ourselves into. The rules kept changing, new requirements kept appearing, new adventures insisted upon placing themselves in our path. Every time we thought we were almost home, we found out about another internal assessment we had to do. Just continuing on was one of the greatest challenges we had to face. On his journey, Odysseus had to pass the sirens, sea creatures with beautiful, hypnotic voices that called sailors away from their missions. Odysseus passed the sirens quickly and was free, but the IB students have always had to listen to the calls of less demanding, less stressful programs. But here we are. We've made it through, except for those tests, the rest of the month. So, when one stays in IB, what does one have to do? Our Greek hero had to traverse a narrow strait between two terrors, a giant man-eating monster, Scylla, and a giant ship-destroying whirlpool, Charybdis. We had to avoid far more than two terrors. However, we can divide our terrors into two groups. On one side, we faced the International Baccalaureate Organization, the monster, which, if we did not appease it, threatened to devour all our work and struggle and give us nothing in return. On the other side, we had normal classwork, the whirlpool that, if ignored, could make the monster irrelevant. How did we deal with our twin terrors? Massive amounts of caffeine. Odysseus visited an island where lotus plants grew. One who ate from these plants forgot his quest and fell into a deep sleep. Textbooks and term papers are our lotuses. We know about fighting sleep. Classen's arts program has been my escape from IB. I walk out of the world of getting things out of the way because we must, and into photography, the world of creating because we want to. And I remember band with Mr. Jernigan, truly a life experience like no other. Part of that experience was the band family. The feeling of really being a part of group is a rare and precious one. And the band family was just such a feeling. We were all in this together. We had effort and experiences in common, and we were all friends because of this, even if we didn't all know each other very well. I was always so proud to be a part of that group, when we won contests, and even when we just sat in class and one of our star members played, and we all listened, amazed at the talent and skill we were associated with. Yes, band was a very special experience. Being a part of the class of 2001 has been very much the same kind of experience on a larger scale. We certainly have effort and experiences in common, and this is, without a doubt, a group to be very proud of. Our visual artists create amazing works that appear everywhere, in contests, on walls, even in the little notebooks where we ask our friends to sign their names and write messages to us. Classen's performing artists are superb. I'm still discovering new areas of talent in our school. Somehow, over all these years, I had managed to miss hearing our bell choir perform, but I finally got to hear them play a few nights ago at the robing ceremony, and I was impressed. That was wonderful. But I wasn't surprised. I know by now to expect excellence from Classen. If one is supporting Klassen, the best part of District History Day and Science Fair competitions is the award ceremony. I particularly remember History Days. We all sat down in the Klassen section and cheered through the entire ceremony as we won award after award after award. However, even at our times of success, disaster was always at our heels. In our first year, as we were getting things off the ground, the tragedy of the Murrah Building bombing came into our community. The explosion was only about a mile from our school building, and we all heard and felt it. That same year, students were traveling to the Odyssey of the Mind World Competition when their bus caught fire. That year's last Classic Chronicle headline read, "They can bomb us, they can burn us, but they can't stop us." On a bus heading home after a competition in Orlando. We were proud of our success at the competition, and all was well until we passed a truck with a sign in its window, "Tornado is coming." Mr. Jernigan told the bus driver to floor it. He saved all our lives. Rebuilding after disaster. I know many of our own lives were touched by this. I'm happy to say that despite everything, most of us have made it through, and we've gained many additional friends along the way. Unfortunately, some have left for other schools, and some are no longer with us at all. We remember teachers, friends, and relatives lost in the last 7 years, and are grateful for the time we spent with them. We are also filled with gratitude for those who are here. Thank you, Linda Barnett and Trina Brown, our class sponsors. Thank you, teachers, Dr. Warner, Ms. Halsey, Hal, Ms. Waters, all of you. School. Thank you to friends and relatives who are here tonight, especially those visiting from out of town. Thank you so much, parents. Thank you to my parents. I have wondered at times what I would be now if I had grown up with different parents, and I can't even imagine it. Thank you for who I am.
Interim superintendent. He is one of the main reasons Klassen School School of Advanced Studies is here today. He believed that a school with an international baccalaureate program in visual and performing arts could work. And here we are, 7 years later, proving that it has. Our speaker this evening is an outstanding educator, committing himself to the schools as well as reaching out to the community. Being on the board of Leadership Oklahoma City, the program co-chair of Youth Leadership Exchange, and serving on the board of the American Red Cross and the Girl Scouts of America, he has shown great leadership and dedication. He has also been completely devoted to everything I have ever done, attending every dance recital and show I've ever performed in. From piano recitals, dance recitals, vocal performances, t-ball games, and soccer games, he's been a wonderful cheerleader and supporter when I needed him. Coming to 9 out of 9 West Side Story shows last summer to see me play a shark proved him to be the best dad there is. I hold my father in such high esteem and hold deeply to my heart every value he has instilled in me. Thank you, Dad, for everything you've done. Ladies and gentlemen, if you would please join me in welcoming my role model and loving father, Dr. Guy Michael Sconza.
I knew this was going to be hard. Jennifer, thank you so much. I do hope someone got that on tape. If you did, I would like a copy. If you'll indulge me just one more second. Diane, thank you for 27 incredible years. Thank you for Jennifer and Michael. Representative Blackburn, former superintendent Dr. Mason, Board of Education members, fellow educators, parents, family members, friends, and most importantly, members of the class in School of Advanced Studies, graduating class of 2001. Thank you so very much for allowing me the opportunity to speak with you briefly this evening on what is, I would say, the most significant and important event in your life to date. But recognize that it is particularly significant and important because you are more than just high school graduates this evening. You are the first high school graduates of the new millennium. You are the class that represents the first high school graduates from Classen to complete the entire 7-year program of studies, the dream that Dr. Mason and many of us had some years ago. So it is especially significant and important as you get ready to move on to the next phase in your life this evening. You know, Mrs. Henderson reminded us this afternoon how many of you as sixth graders in 1994 literally helped to open Classen. I'm sure some of you remember the Saturday and the Sunday preceding the Monday that the school was to open, because many of you, with your parents and family members, came to that building and you moved chairs and desks into rooms, and you've cleaned lockers, and you sorted books, and you literally opened Classen School of Advanced Studies on time. Just 7 years later, as high school seniors, you then accomplished the most massive TPing of a school ever witnessed by mankind. Quite a work of art, and very apropos for the visual and performing arts part of the school. You're graduating from Classen School of Advanced Studies, a dream come true. Just last month, and if you didn't know this, I really want you to remember this, just last month, Classen School of Advanced Studies was honored by the Oklahoma State Board of Regents as the best in the state for academically preparing students for college. That is an incredible distinction. We really need to pause and thank you, the graduates, for that distinction. You made it happen. You did it because you worked and you learned at a level truly unparalleled by any of your peers across the state. We need to thank your teachers and the staff at Classen School of Advanced Studies for teaching and guiding you over the years in ways that I promise you is envied by many schools across the state of Oklahoma. And we especially need to thank your parents for providing the essential support to you and to your education in Classen for all of these years. Thank you to all of you. Well, we're just literally a couple of 3 minutes away from your moving on, your name being called, you're walking across the stage, which will signify and symbolize you're moving on to the next phase in your life. And as you do that, I really only want to make one suggestion, and I hope I can make it strongly to each and every one of you. And that is that more than any other human characteristic, quality, or trait, the one thing that really makes the difference in whether or not a person experiences success is having a positive attitude. More than any other characteristic, trait, or quality, it's having a positive attitude that makes the difference. Just think about it. The difference between those who succeed and those who don't, as far as abilities or skills or knowledge, frankly, is often very small and very insignificant. It's having the positive attitude, I suggest, that makes the difference. If you know anything about baseball, realize, and you do realize, that the difference between a 250 batting average and a 350 batting average is a huge difference in the rewards that a baseball player can receive. But do you realize that the difference between those two averages is one hit in every 10 times at bat? In the game of golf, and you look at golf tournaments, over the course of a three-day golf tournament, it is one stroke, it's one swing of the club that makes the difference between winning a tournament and not winning a tournament. And for all of the people who compete not only in those venues, but frankly in every venue, the difference in their abilities and skills and knowledge is very, very small. Where the difference really lies in having a positive attitude. And you know, the great thing about a positive attitude is God has given all of us the capacity to choose to have one. Each and every morning when we wake up, we have the choice as to whether or not to have a positive attitude. We control that. We have the power to feel however we want to feel. So we can make the difference. So let me share one story with you as I come to a close. To make that point, I hope, even clearer. Some of you may have heard of a former professional baseball player by the name of Pete Rose. Pete Rose's distinction in his baseball career is he set the all-time record for most hits by a player. Just before the season, when everyone expected Pete to break Ty Cobb's all-time record of most hits, Pete Rose was in a press conference, and one of the reporters in that press conference shouted out to Rose, "Hey, Pete, how many at-bats do you think it's going to take for you to get the 78 hits to break Ty Cobb's record?" And immediately, Pete Rose responded, 78. There was dead silence for a few seconds. And that reporter came back and questioned Rose again, and he asked, "Come on, Pete, you don't really mean that. You don't think it's going to take only 78 at-bats to get 78 hits, do you?" And Rose's reply was, "Yes, I do. Every time I step up to the plate, I expect to get a hit. If I didn't expect to get a hit, then I have no right to step up to the plate." As soon-to-be graduates of Classen School of Advanced Studies, you have the wherewithal to feel that very same level of confidence, to have that very same positive attitude. succeed in all that you face and all that you pursue. You have accomplished so much. You have given all of us so many reasons to feel so proud this evening. But you have so much more to do. Remember, only the dead have done enough. You have more to accomplish. You have places to go and goals and dreams to achieve. So on behalf of your parents, your teachers, your family members and friends, all of us here this evening, I wish for each and every one of you that you live as long as you want and never want as long as you live. Godspeed to you all.
Terms for the parents who have been with us since the beginning. We call them 7-year veterans and founding parents. You're a member of this distinguished group of fantastic, hardworking people, being the father of 2 children to graduate from Klassen, Michael in 1997 and Jennifer tonight. But your involvement goes way beyond the role of parent. You're willing to take a risk, not only as a parent, but as a leader. As many of you know, Dr. Guy Sconzo was the assistant superintendent of schools during the planning stages and opening of Klassen School of Advanced Studies. You worked closely with Dr. Betty Mason to make a vision a reality. Your commitment to this program, your guidance, and your leadership has been a gift to each of us here tonight. Dr. Sconzo, the first time I met you, I was a 5th grader at a backyard barbecue. And actually, I probably paid more attention that night to your daughter and the other kids than I did to you. It is with great pleasure tonight that I pay tribute to you as I present this trophy. It seems fitting that just as you helped start our school, one of the last official acts as an administrator of the Oklahoma City Public Schools is to offer the 2001 commencement address at Klassen School of Advanced Studies. Those of us graduating tonight, thank you not only for the words you've just spoken, but for the commitment you've made to us, to our classes, and to our school over the past 7 years. Thank you, Dr. Sconzo.
This is the moment. This is the day when I send all demons on their way. Every endeavor I have made ever is coming into play. It's here and now, today.
parents and families of the class of 2001. It is with pride that I present the Class and School of Advanced Studies graduating class of 2001 who have fulfilled for graduation the requirements of the state of Oklahoma and for the Oklahoma City Public Schools. I now present the class of 2001.
Dr. Maxfield, upon your recommendation and your certification that these young men and women have met the requirements for graduation and in compliance with the regulations of the Oklahoma State Board of Education and to the Oklahoma City Board of Education, I hereby declare that the members of the class of 2001 as graduates of the Oklahoma City Public Schools and Klassen School of Advanced Studies, congratulations to each of you on this momentous occasion.
Yeah!
It was there that she saw the value of a performing arts magnet high school. But she didn't stop there. She recognized the value of visual arts as well. Dr. Mason understood that students who excel academically also tend to be artistic and vice versa. It was under her direction as superintendent of schools in Oklahoma City that Klassen School of Advanced Studies was developed. Dr. Mason, would you please come up here?
Thank you.
school. The first day of classes being reopened. Half the school had no electricity. It was hot. Most of the classes weren't ready, so we were packed like sardines in different rooms. And for a little guy like me, 4 foot nothing and chubby, the place was huge. A monstrosity of 3 floors, spaced out in 3 different hall sections. With room numbers C3108 and A106 and 8 different classes to attend. What is day one or day two? And what is this about Tuesdays is day one and sometimes Mondays are day two? But you know, that was not what I was afraid of. When I came to classing, I didn't know anybody but two who had attended my elementary school. And believe it or not, I was a very shy kid. But I realized later that I wasn't alone. Here was a diverse group of more than 600 to 800 kids who basically didn't know anyone either. Everyone from the 6th grade to the 10th grade, that 94-95 school year, were lost. We all found our niche and became a family. We have gone from learning how to multiply and divide decimals and mixed numbers to solving complex algebraic equations. From learning a point and click on a PC to writing our own computer programs and designing our own websites. From learning about proven scientific theories to researching our own scientific theories. From reading sheet music to composing our own music. From learning the parts of speech to writing our own speeches. From learning how to stand in first position in ballet to choreographing our own complex dance numbers. We have gone from drawing Ninja Turtles, Power Rangers, and collecting comic books to creating our own comic strips. From learning the parts of a stage to starring in our own theatrical stage productions. From just doodling and sketching whatever comes to mind to making masterpieces that can be seen from the hallways of our school to these beautiful banners that are behind us. And artwork all across this nation. And for me, being short and chubby to just being short. We have socially come from loving each other, hating each other, and come back to loving each other time and time again. Yes, we have come a long way. Yes, 7 years long. But we couldn't have done it ourselves. We had to that rehearsal, who has volumes of pictures and videotapes of all our performances, who keep pushing us to keep trying and never giving up because they pay too much for that instrument, that expensive calculator, those ballet shoes, that presentation board, those science projects, and those sketchbooks. The people who have dealt and who still deals with all of our mood swings, who let us play sick when we get stretched out, who helped us fundraise and fundraise till they just couldn't fundraise anymore. These people are the true key to our success. Beautiful and loving parents. Thank you so much, parents.
did more than teach, but became our second mothers and fathers, staying late after school, helping us with whatever we needed, tutoring us, and just being there when we needed someone to talk to. That's when they became more than educators. They became our friends. Thanks for instilling wisdom, knowledge, and a hope for the future in us. Before I close, I would like to thank all the family members, relatives, and friends who have come to support us today, this night. To my Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ.
Administration.